And then sometimes we were waiting for the lamb to fall asleep. And,
yeah.
And I was like tiptoeing in and sat down. And then the lamb was like, bah! And like, everyone out again. Okay, start again.
I made like a sketchbook with drawings and paintings, and then met Sean, and he liked it, and we start, you know, working.
How many years did it take you to write the script? It was almost like a baby that was like slowly growing in you.
Yeah, you know, after a few years, we made a treatment, and when Ron and Sarah liked it, you know, then Sean took over and started writing the script, and then, you know, and it took a few years, so, you know, it was a very, what do you say, organic process, I feel. We knew the story very well.
It's, I feel like it's something really, like, deeply personal for you. It came out of you, and I grew up on a farm, and as soon as I came up there, I grew up between Sweden and Iceland, and when I came up to Akureyri, where we shot it, and we started, like, you know, kind of getting into that whole, the universe, the lamb universe, nature and the animals and you and me and the other actors kind of melted and we became like one family.
Mm-hmm.
It was so powerful, like I've never felt that. And it was like me coming back to my roots.
Yeah, I maybe it was a little bit like we were all the crew,
yeah.
Just farmers.
You know, we were farmers.
Because, you know, some crew members also lived.
Yeah.
At the, you know, location where we're shooting.
I remember we were waiting for the lambs to start getting born, and I was shooting something in New Orleans, and I arrived and I was waiting in my trailer, and then it came, like, there's a lamb coming. And I was like running down to the farmhouse and basically pulling out a lamb out of the mother sheep. And then I saw life, you know, life begin, and how this little creature, like, you know, kind of taking its first breath. And that says so much. That was the movie, I feel.
Yeah.
You know, the kind of the rawness of life and how fragile we are and how beautiful we are and that we're all connected, you know? Me and the sheep mama and the mother sheep are the same spirit in a way. Very much so. And how do you heal? And what does grief do to you? And I had this feeling when we started working that Maria was living on 50% almost, that she closed some doors inside to survive, and she becomes a doer. She works and she doesn't feel a lot, and then slowly through this journey she started breathing and feeling, and through Atta, this great gift given to her, she started, you know, getting like emotional oxygen into her lungs and heart again.
Mm-hmm.
And then she allows herself to feel the pain, and that's where the healing process also starts, and then she finds her voice, sort of. The mother instinct kicks in.
Mm.
The rational mind, it's not functioning anymore. You're purely primitive. And we are savage, you know? And in that space, there's a lot of brutality. There's a lot of tenderness, but also brutality.
Yeah, you know, it was a small crew, I think 35 people,
yeah.
Or something. But
and most of them are your friends, your childhood,
yeah,
friends.
Yeah.
He was very intimate.
But me and Eli Arison, my DP, we had spent so much time, you know, preparing, you know, we knew all the frames, and I had also, just after finished the script, I just did a, you know, like a storyboard for the whole script, and then we probably did it two more times, we
But you were so prepared, at the same time you were wide open.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Every day, it was this magical combination.
Because, you know, because of the animals, so you have to be a little bit open.
Because of the animals,
you know,
and so. This animal too. Yeah. I don't feel like it belongs to a genre, which makes it, for me, even more special. I feel like you, Sean, and us, everyone around, we created something that's like the lamb universe, and it moves in a shade land between different different genres, I would say.
I think I always thought about it as an arthouse film, you know, with this strange surrealistic element, you know.
It's like dream, nightmare, reality are melted into one. And you know, we are chaos. A human child and a baby lamb. It was very real.
Yeah.
We shot like one scene with the lamb and then one with the baby, and then sometimes the baby had like the bald cap, the CGI, like the green, and then he pulled it off and it was just the baby. We had to be quite patient.
Yeah. I you know, I'm so thankful for that because, you know, we basically have to do the scene probably like, first with puppets,
yeah,
then with babies, yeah, and then with real lambs. You know?
And then sometimes we were waiting for the lamb to fall asleep. And
yeah.
For like 20 minutes, and then someone was like, you know, stroking the lamb, and then I was like tiptoeing in and sat down, and then the lamb was like, bah! And like everyone out again. Okay, start again.
I really appreciate that, you know, how patient everybody was,
yeah,
you know.
Do you remember when I was on the bed when I was supposed to be sleeping, and the cat was supposed to jump up on the bed? This cat was such a diva.
Yeah.
I mean, and they were throwing like cat candy on me for the cat to jump up on the bed, and I was like getting the candy in my face, trying to pretend that I was sleeping, and the cat was just watching the candy hit me and not moving. And we tried and tried until I started laughing.
Yeah, it was always, he was always doing what we wanted him to do, you know, the day after when we arrived.
Yeah, he was
then
very...
he was sitting at the place we wanted to him to
he
be.
He was like, you don't control me. Me and him had a hard relationship.
There are so many films, you know. Children of Nature.
I did my very first film when I was 7 in Iceland, and it was called Skugga Hrafnsins. It means In the Shadow of the Raven. Mm. That was a crazy. He did 2 films back then. Hrafn Gunnlaugsson, who was like, for me as a 7-year-old, that's where everything started for me. He was very intense, very loud, and it was like one night where it was like 2 in the morning, you know, we've been working 18 hours and people wanted to go home. And he was like, what is wrong with you? You're not passionate. And he was like, how old are you? I was like 7. He's like, look, she's not complaining. That's a real actress. And I was like, okay, I'm an actress. That's how it started for me. And he was quite iconic back then.
Yeah.
In the 80s. But that was what I grew up on, like Viking films, like really brutal and raw. Blood and like, you know, full on romantic.
Rams was here a few years back, and Noel Alpinoy.
But it's incredible how so many of the Scandinavian countries are now exploding out with like so many amazing directors.